tough guy's gonna do it? Who's gonna take on the champ?
So create dance. I am a can of whoop ass ready to open. I really wish these niggas would stop fronting on me.
Niggas try to front, we move on them. Niggas think something sweet till we move on them.
SlickJC, your notorious B.I.G., brother in gaming, you know, that YouTube guy, you all know and love, and I'm back with another 1v1 Call of Duty match here. I guess the third time it's going to be the charm. You know, you saw the video from Monday on Getaway, where me and that fella was training kills back and forth, till he decided he just couldn't win. And he just had to hit the start button and just end the game. He couldn't take it. He had to leave. Then you saw Wednesday's video, Modern Warfare 3 on a map lookout. And you saw how me and that fella was trading kills to the point where I don't know, used the force or whatever. You know, I pretty much figure, hey, can't snipe something that's moving so fast. You just gotta keep on rushing them. And, you know, I kept on rushing them. And I started running up the score, and he was like, oh, I gotta go. So I said, let me try my hand at something that I haven't played in a long while. You know, I had purchased this game again from Walmart for $20 not too long ago. And the day of this recording, I had played and recorded a few team death matches that you probably will see in the near future. I ran into a hack lobby in the middle of a match, in which you'll see part of that in the near future. Cause it was crazy how that was going on, what was going on in that match. But I only could get in the team death match while I was playing the game. And then I was recording, you know, on this game, headquarters was my favorite game mode. But I couldn't get into a headquarters, you know, it showed two or three people getting the lobby, and it's like five people in total, and it's just sitting there waiting for players, waiting for players. So I'm like, look, I'm not trying to fall asleep here, waiting for players. So let me just switch the game mode up. And so I tried that, I tried domination, and I even tried ground war, and I just couldn't get anything. And so as I'm scrolling down, I'm looking, I see cage match. You know, my mind is gone. I'm like, what in the world's cage match? Because I ain't had a game in so long. I scroll down to cage match. I look at the description of the thing. 1v1 match. Oh. I said, let me try this out. I said, let me make sure my PVR is hooked up to my laptop still. Let me get ready to record this. Because something might go down. Which it did. Man, nothing. There's no hack or nothing going on in this. No, it is straight up one-on-one. Both of us had good internet connections, so nobody had the advantage of anybody getting the kills. But my man raised crits at the end while we was tied up. And so I figured, well, since he raised crit, that means the win is mine. Now, I want to talk about Call of Duty as a franchise, since you know there's gonna be another one coming in November. And I'm watching a video by another guy that I'm sub to, and he was talking about, can YouTubers and gamers help make the perfect Call of Duty? And, you know, they can if these companies take the opinions and ideas from, I don't want to say the average, but the normal gamer. You know, don't be hitting up Optic, Quickscope and Clan, and whatnot, to get, you know, ideas and stuff of what to implement in your game. All these game developers had to do for Call of Duty is look at the elements that has worked for them in each game, and then take those elements and put them all together in one game. All right, let's start with this one. Modern Warfare. No lag comp. Check. All the master me on this one were great. Some big, some small, they worked. So basically, for this one, which is those things, not even the factor that made this game different than any other games that was out there. It was the introduction of the kill streaks. So the kill streaks is what I would take from this game towards building the perfect Call of Duty. I know y'all about to say, oh, it's kill streaks and all the rest of them after that. Yeah. But this one only had three. And everybody had the same three. You know, the UAV, the artillery, which you got to choose 3 points to drop it on. And then the attack helicopter, which you just called in and it circled the map a couple of times and shot some people up. That's it. You know, in this game, I think people really had a problem with the perks like the juggernaut and things like that. But other than that, this game's fine. Perfect, in my opinion. World at War. They had an element of that game that carried over into the other two Treyarch games, which is the zombie mode. So for World at War, zombies. Also for World at War that I liked were on the bigger maps, you had tanks that you can get into and drive around and shoot people for a little bit till they blew you up. You know, I guess they was kind of stole that element from Battlefield by having a vehicle on the board, but it wasn't on every board. It was like one or two of them. So that's what I take from that. You know, carryover zombie mode had one or two maps that got like a tank on it, tank or two on it. Modern Warfare 3. The only thing I take, not Modern Warfare 3, Modern Warfare 2, I mean. The only thing I take from that is maybe the look of it. Because that was with the, you know, you had the banners and achievements, things, you know, you unlock little emblems and stuff like that. You know, that was cool. Well, it didn't really change what the game was or whatnot. But I wouldn't go with all those kill streaks, and definitely no nuke. Because with that, that started to change how people play. People went from playing the objective, playing for fun, playing to win, to playing for kill streaks. Which led to like the ultimate camping and all that. Alright, running out of time. Black Ops. Combat training. Theater mode. Which is, has carried over. The theater mode has carried over to Modern Warfare 3 and Black Ops 2. Modern Warfare 3. Face-off mode. With the 1v1, the 2v2, and the 3v3. Great addition to the Call of Duty series. Black Ops 2. I hate the game so much. It's incomplete. But if I had to take something from it, it'd be the Peak 10 Creative Class system. So that'd be my perfect Call of Duty. No lag comp. Only 3 set kill streaks. Zombies. Combat training. the three levels of face-off, and the Pick 10 Creator Class System. With those things together in one Call of Duty game will be great. Oh, and also the dive. You know, the dive does wonders. All right, y'all, I'm up out of here. SlickJC, Toys B.I.G., peace.
Yo, you got the juice now, man.
And speaking of Black Ops 2, I just want to get a rant on Black Ops 2 that I hate Black Ops 2. Straight up. It's October 25th. I'm going to let you know right now, I hate Black Ops 2. I feel like taking the disc and snapping it in half, even though the game ain't even out yet. I know y'all like, yo, SlickJC, you a bugging, son. The game come out November 13th. How the hell you going to hate the game? I hate it, man.